William will wed his college sweetheart, Kate Middleton, at Westminster Abbey in London. CNN's royal wedding contributor, Cat Deeley, joins us from London. And Cat, I mean, this is exciting for a lot of people. You're going to be covering the big event for CNN in London. It's April 29th. Anderson Cooper, Piers Morgan, I know you guys are all going to be there together. You know, we saw these fingernail decals, the coffee mugs, the Legos, the whole bit. A lot of buzz here around this. Why do you think there is such interest in the royal couple, particularly among the 20-30-somethings?
You know what? I think it's because they're a new set of royal family for a new generation. You know, they've kind of put protocol to one side, and it's very much the fairy tale, you know? I think that they're in a very modern relationship. They've been together for 9-10 years. It seems to be able to work. They've obviously learned from their predecessors. And now it looks as though it's really going to, you know, it's really going to work. I've been lucky enough to meet Prince William and Prince Harry a few times, and they're so great. There isn't all the protocol. You don't have to stand in a line. You don't have to bow. They're just young, handsome, charming men that handled themselves so brilliantly, you know, during all the tragedy that happened in their lives. And now they're thoroughly modern, and they're new royals for a new generation.
That's pretty cool. And everybody around the world are going to be watching this ceremony live. I'd imagine it's a lot of pressure to be under when you're a bride and a groom. Everybody is watching what could possibly go wrong, as have been things gone wrong in previous royal weddings. You have any predictions on how this is all going to go down?
Well, I think she's going to handle herself very, very well. I think that's the thing with Kate, is she seems to have got into the royal family and just handled herself absolutely immaculately every step of the way. And I think they've been coaching her very well, too. I mean, there was the big thing at Charles and Diana's wedding where she got the names mixed up and she got them muddled up and the wrong way around. And I actually think that the general public found that incredibly endearing. You know, mistakes do happen. They happen at every wedding that we've ever been to. And I actually find that incredibly charming. As long as she doesn't fall over, touch wood, she doesn't fall over, we'll be fine.
She probably won't fall over. We've all had those moments where we've made a little mistake here or there. What do we know about the dress? There's a lot of talk about who the designer is, and it's all very quiet right now.
Absolutely. There's been lots and lots of speculation here in London. And actually, I think it's more interesting who's not talking than the people who are talking, because I think the people who are talking really know that they're definitely not doing the dress. I would love to see Sarah Burton actually design the dress, who's the lady who's taken over from Alexander McQueen. She was his right-hand woman. And I think what would be so delightful about her designing Kate's dress would it would be chic and elegant and timeless. And it's also a tip of the hat as well to Alexander McQueen and the stunning work that he did. I think it's going to be very chic. I think it's going to be very classic. I think she will have sleeves. Uh-huh. But I'd love to see something a little bit different too.
And you're reporting for CNN, but you're also hosting a series on BBC America called Royally Mad. Tell us what we can expect from the show.
Yeah. Oh, it was just really good fun. We filmed it already. We took 5 royally obsessed, mad American fans to London, and we brought them here, and we gave them experiences that money couldn't buy, and we introduced them to people who've worked with the royals or are friends with the royals, and we travelled all around London. And it was so nice for me, one, because I was home, so that was just a lovely, lovely feeling, and two, to see how much joy they got out of all the different experiences through their eyes was completely infectious. I was suddenly like, oh my God, I love this town, you know? It was so nice to be able to show them my home and them actually really, really enjoy it. So it was great. We've shown one part already on BBC America, and the next part goes out next week.
All right. Looks like a lot of fun. Kat, thanks so much for joining us. Mm-hmm. We'll be watching.
Thank you so much.
Sure. This programming note on Sunday, April 24th at 8 p.m. Eastern, CNN takes you behind the scenes with CNN Presents the women who would be queen. You too can be part of our global viewing party. It is going to be a party. Join Anderson Cooper, Piers Morgan, Richard Quest, and Cat Deeley as they bring you every moment. CNN's coverage of the royal wedding Friday, April 29th, starts at 4 a.m. Eastern. Plus, check in on everything to do with the royal wedding whenever you want by going to cnn.com/royalwedding.